Unfortunately, my I still call her my wife, but legally she's my ex-wife now.
I hate to say this, but very much moved on.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, and there's the problem. She was at the game with her new boyfriend.
Strong guy, that guy.
Yeah, I mean, he could be the this is gay mascot. Mm-hmm. This guy looked like a positive image of a gay man. I wish he was gay.
Sure.
But based on the public displays of affection I was seeing between him and my
aggressive
wife.
Aggressive public displays.
Absolutely. A little too much for a high school basketball game, if you ask me.
I mean, at one point, I looked up from my blind rage on the court, and I saw him topless.
Yeah. Well, he was fighting through his food poisoning. Because he was the center for the basketball team that defeated us.
right. That's why he was so big and strong. He was a high school athlete.
He's a young, beautiful, strapping man who's dating your wife.
I mean, to me, he looked like he was 93 years old, but everybody else has said he looks young and beautiful and that I have some sort of cognitive dissonance going on because I can't stand the fact that my wife is now dating a 17-year-old college basketball prospect.
And that guy's funny, too.
Yeah, he had some hilarious roasts.
Man, I couldn't believe they gave him the mic at halftime and just let him go to town on you. That 17-year-old tore you apart.
I mean, I thought I was watching Don Rickles again.
Yeah. Stature and everything.
Yeah. I mean, the bull came out, they played his song, and he went to town on you. And
I had no line of defense. I was flummoxed because I'm expecting a halftime show, and instead, a 17-year-old high school basketball center is roasting me like he's Rickles, and I'm some fat guy in a Hawaiian shirt in the audience, which I'm only one of.
Yeah, you weren't wearing a Hawaiian shirt at all.
No, sir. Well, he took his shirt off, and I tried to go toe-to-toe with him. Anyway, things ended up getting physical. He beat me up pretty bad. But I instigated it, so the cops ended up taking me away, which is kind of a public humiliation because I did miss a tech rehearsal the next morning for the play.
Oh, that's a shame.
Yeah. I mean, I imagine feeling like you're letting those high schoolers down. 32 kids sitting there in their audience.
With literally nothing to do.
With nothing to applaud.
Now, yeah, your audience costumes, that's just their regular clothes, right?
Well, yeah, I have them kind of picking a character for the audience.
And they're kind of thumbing through a program?
Yeah, which they're providing themselves.